Have you ever tried VR? Did you ever feel a little sick? Maybe it's not all in your head, maybe it's in your chromosomes. Hey guys, Julia here for D News. Virtual reality is racing full steam ahead into being one of the fastest growing areas of future entertainment. I've tried it, it's a lot of fun. Full headset with goggles and headphones. But it's still a little ways off from revolutionizing the world. One main challenge is that men seem to have a better experience with it than women. Before we get to that, let's take a look at how VR works in the brain. One study published in the journal Nature Neuroscience found that the brain treats the space in VR as different from the real world. Neurophysicists from UCLA were originally searching for clues on Alzheimer's, specifically in regards to the hippocampus, a part of the brain that deals with memory, but also with spatial awareness and creating the mental map of the environment. In the study, they tracked the neuron activity of rats as they entered a room, and then as they entered the same room, but only on a VR system. They were studying to see if the brain would respond the same way with both rooms, even though the VR room wouldn't have smell or sound. Researchers found that the brain responded very differently depending on the situation. When the rats were in the VR room, their neurons fired randomly, suggesting they had no idea where they were in space. And what's more interesting, half the neurons that fired in the real room were fired in the VR room. It was like half their neurons were shut down in the fake space. So maybe there's something missing from VR with our other senses. The researchers think we take in clues from sounds and even smells to figure out where we are in real space. But headphones easily fix the sound problem, but other problems are a little trickier to solve. VR is also missing virtual movement, our inner sense called theta-phase precession, and our sense of where our body parts are, which is called proprioception. But some companies are working on this, like the Virtuix Omni, which is a treadmill to walk on as you use the Oculus Rift. You're attached to this harness and almost buckled into this cage thing so you won't fall off. Writer Raymond Wong compared it to a baby walker. And VR is missing things from its visual systems too, something that could lead to gender bias in VR. Basically, there's two ways your eyes perceive things like depth. Motion parallax, which is when something is moving towards you, it gets bigger in your perception, and shape from shading. When you move around an object, your eye picks up on subtle clues from shadows. As you move around the object, the shadows change, but your eye does this by flickering ever so slightly. But sex hormones act on the eye and the retina strongly, so men and women literally see things differently. Women tend to rely on shape from shading to judge depth and dimension. Men seem to rely more on motion parallax. VR, while it's made great strides in the past decade, still isn't the greatest when it comes to shape from shading. According to Dana Boyd, principal researcher at Microsoft Research and the founder of Data and Society Research Institute, computers are terrible at simulating that tiny constant flickering of your eyes, so VR systems mostly rely on motion parallax. What does that mean? Well, Boyd suggests it could be a possible reason so many women get sick from VR. A system that makes half the world's population sick still needs more research, but it's definitely something to look forward to in the future. Just like all the cool innovations Intel is working on. Intel creates the breakthrough technologies that make amazing experiences possible. Having Intel inside makes for better experiences outside. Intel drives innovation with products like processors, wearables, and IoT devices, and within data centers, in the PC and beyond. While VR gets better every year, one thing it seems to be really good at is virtual sex. Check out this video from our friends over at Seeker.
The term teledildonics is a blanket term to describe tools, toys, and wearables that can help recreate the physical side of a sexual partner. This all stems from haptic technology, which uses vibrations or force to stimulate the sense of touch.
So what improvements do you want to see from VR? Have you ever tried it? Tell us about it down in the comments below. Don't forget to hit those like and subscribe buttons and keep coming back to D News so you don't miss a single episode.